All right, guys, Paisteboy here. It is day two, where we left off yesterday. Have the motor pulled on Mark's sled. Parker's here again, and we're gonna finish it up. We got all those broken off studs pulled out of the motor. No problems there. And so let's take a look at what we're working with here today. Fuel or
no,
something.
It's not. What is it? Blows up. I don't know why.
All right. Well, I thought I was about to blow up here. Yeah. So we left off. We had all the bolts out. Parker is mounting the starter here. Say hi, Parker.
Get in with the starter attached.
We're just mounting it just to see the length of these bolts and just make sure that the threads aren't damaged at all. Because we're going to have to take it out, take the starter off to put it back
in. Yeah, because you noticed yesterday there was some debris in the threading, and that's part of the reason why the bolts weren't screwing in all the way before.
Mm-hmm. The other thing I was thinking, should we put like a sleeve in there? Because the hole on the starter is bigger than the bolt.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Like a bushing or something.
So I don't want it.
Yeah.
The starter
to be able to shift. Well, let's see what we can find. I don't know. There probably wasn't one initially, right?
This one.
Right, this is the one that's
because
you think that was moving around?
Yeah, because when you only had two bolts in there, it was just going like that.
That's true.
What was it doing?
Look at this one.
How was it going?
So that one, good, oval,
like put,
completely oval.
But put the bolt in and wiggle it around.
And I'm guessing that became oblong because it didn't have enough.
It's either that or it was just like that to be able to adjust to get it
true,
out.
Right.
I mean, it's hard to say, but...
Right, all right, so...
This is the only one that wasn't broken, so if I had to guess, that it's that one.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess it isn't that much play, but you would think it'd be a little tighter, right? This one, I think, is tighter than this one.
I don't think it'll really matter, especially with the lock washers when we get enough pressure on there.
All right, so let's get that set up. All right, so we're going to go in Parker's car. We're going to go back to his house, which is his dad's house, Shag's house, and grab a stator for Mark's sled. Ready?
Raise Cameron.
Okay, so I have, what was it, last year's video from the Rochester Snowmobile Show. I had about a minute of some 300-year-old Christmas song that you can't really even hear in the background. And it got flagged by YouTube, so I couldn't make any money on that video. And then I ended up using their new feature where it's supposed to remove the audio. Yeah, it removed it, all of it. So there's like a minute of dead air in the video. And now I'm sure that video's not making squat anyway. And then the 2019 Toronto Snowmobile Show video, you barely could even hear that there's music underneath all the noise of the crowd there. And YouTube caught it. It was like another 300-year-old Christmas song that I didn't even recognize. And I'm making like 3 cents on the video now because of it.
Common whatever? Because the song's so old?
Nope.
Really?
It's copyright infringement.
That's ridiculous.
So I have to share the revenue.
Some of those songs are owned by nobody.
Well, apparently that one was.
Because all these old songs, after like 40 years or something, or 50 years, it's owned by nobody.
Right. Any way you slice it, it's not a strike against me, but now most of the revenue that I would have made off of that video is now,
you know what's funny?
Gone.
This video is now double educational. You learned about copyright music and snowmobiles.
Right.
Double!
And that's why I can't put Motley Crue songs in my videos.
That's a shame, because they jam.
Yeah,
shame.
I actually have a video from years and years ago, Senzi Cycles open house, and I actually put the music in there myself, not thinking straight. And
Have you put any music stuff on your channel in a while?
Yes, like in my videos, I use the YouTube approved music.
No, I'm saying like, do they know that you guys have a band and everything?
I haven't put up a video of our bands in quite a few years. The last one I did was quite...
Rick doesn't make any money off of that, right?
No. Anyway.
You got to bring this in, like I said, next week if you can, so we can look at it, because I'll be at Mount Reed after next week.
Okay. All right, let's jam some music.
All right. So this freaking guy here, they're supposed to yield and said, let me just jump out in front of them as they come straight.
What a sweet person on a Sunday, nonetheless.
I know.
The Lord's Day.
Yeah.
Minga, I'll tell you.
I know. People.
Ayana.
Lucky Ayana. Parker is a very safe driver who was doing the speed limit, didn't even have to react, but the guy should have waited. You know?
Should have just rammed him. $1,000 car.
Jackass!
Bumper to bumper.
At least when I cut somebody off, I freaking nail it and my truck goes.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If you're going to pull out in front of somebody, have the common courtesy to accelerate to the speed limit.
Quickly,
yeah.
Yeah, like you start to get mad and then you're like, all right, they're speeding up.
But exactly.
There's always like that.
If you don't have a car that can accelerate quickly, don't pull out in front of me.
Luckily, I've got this race Camry.
Yes.
2.4 liters.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, we didn't record your little screech there.
Yeah, I can show them my new sled too if you
want. Yeah, let's do that. So, here we are. This is Shag's place, and Parker obviously lives here with his dad.
Yep.
And so, somebody's coming.
What up?
Hey, it's the Shagmeister.
What are you doing?
We're videoing. We're working on Mark's, we're working on Zook's sled here.
Proud of my boy helping you out.
Oh, yeah. He's a big help. I haven't done squat.
You were sitting around smoking and
yeah.
I was like working on it.
Yeah.
He's there for moral support.
Yes, I'm there for moral support.
And to feed me, too. He's
a big rip.
And Parker's there for oral support.
So, yeah, here's Shag's sled. You guys know his sled here.
Yep.
It was in all last year's videos. Nice 2014 XRS 800.
Here all summer, right? Didn't you have it in the
storage unit?
No, I said it was in all last year's videos.
No, I didn't remember it being here.
Where's your sled, Parker?
It's in the trailer right
now. All right, we're going to go to the storage container. And look at Parker's sled.
No, it's in the trailer.
The trailer.
Oh, it's in the trailer.
Open and close.
Oh yeah, careful. This is the one that wailed you in the head.
This trailer's seen better days.
What happened to this lid on this thing? Why did it get all cranked up?
There's a multitude.
Is that the one your grandpa bought?
Yeah.
Okay, so here's Shag's father, Parker's grandfather, buys this, what is it, 03? 01 600.
It's in mint shape, though.
Yeah.
It's like
He couldn't pass up the deal, even though his dad hasn't ridden a sled in 40 years.
I actually want him to keep it.
I know, right? Be good. I know.
One pull. This is nice. I'll get you guys a two-stroke small.
All right, so here's Parker's sled. Uh-oh. See, the Articam won't start in one pull. Right? So what do we got here? I can't hear you. What? So, tell us a little about the sled here.
So, this is a 2016 Articat 8000 RR.
Awesome.
So, it's the race replica edition. So, it's got the big reservoir flux float shocks.
Nice.
Yeah, I just got it. Probably going to ride it for a little bit and then probably sell it.
You're not going to keep it for the whole season?
No, probably not.
You're crazy, dude.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, as long as you've got it for most of the season.
What are those sliders and belt for?
For that.
Oh, did Gramps bought that too?
No, he gave it to him with the brand new bell.
What year is that one? 02?
01. Just got a lot of miles, 6,900 miles.
Doesn't matter. Mine had freaking about the same, right? That's didn't have 60 something? I'm pretty sure.
The track.
You need a skid?
Yeah, the track.
That's the. Look at. That's the BRP logo. This is the original track. 6,900 miles.
That's crazy.
It was a 65-year-old man. You think he's the kind of guy that sees a patch of rocks and gasses it to try and wheelie?
Nice. So, those sliders look so short.
What do you mean?
What do you mean? What do you mean? They're usually like freaking another 2 feet longer.
Look at the size of that.
I know.
You know what I mean?
Maybe I already cut them. They're usually way longer. I mean, those wouldn't fit on my skid.
I don't know.
No, I got the 129.
Yeah, that's
definitely like 4 or 5 inches longer.
This is a 129.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a little dirty. We've been mudding it.
We just took them out.
Oh, when we had that foot of snow?
Yeah.
Snow's gone now.
See my yard all tore up.
Oh, you rode it here?
Yeah.
Jeez. See, Shag's got some depth to his yard. We can do some drags here.
If you look way out there, there's a couple strips. See, it's like a dirt strip.
Yeah.
That's my son.
Of course.
Everybody says, hey, it's a blessing to have a kid that's into this stuff. No, it's not.
But we were doing the same things when we were his age anyway. The sleds weren't as fast.
I remember your brother and I like tearing up our yard and yelling at
them. Oh, yeah. Or tearing it up with the truck, trying to pull a sled up from the back, right? And I got in trouble for my brother Mark's messes.
Is this the preseason video?
It is. It's one of them. Let's go look at that cover you got down there.
What cover?
That green thing. Isn't that like a sled trailer cover?
Yeah,
Parker's tell us a little about it.
But you know what's under it? There.
No.
It's a carcass for a rat.
Actually, there might be a skunk under it, too. I saw one back here.
Nice.
Hey, we can walk freely. There's no dog in the backyard.
Dog what?
Wait, you're dog poopy?
Oh, okay. You don't have a dog shag?
Got a little lean built over here.
It's so much easier not having a pet, right?
Got three animals. Their names are Ryan, Paige, and Parker.
Oh, okay.
It's pretty messy.
So this is like a semi-enclosure? Single. Yeah, for a single?
Actually, I bought two of them, and I was gonna, kind of gonna put it on my, like, single trailer.
Yeah.
But my trailer is kind of small. I thought about just keeping it and putting
all three revs.
This is what Parker's going to...
This is my ride for my single.
That's just... Right. That's the same as
Parker's going to ride this once he sells that Snow Pro.
No, he's going to rebuild that.
Mm-hmm. It's good to go, right?
Yeah, it's pretty
just much. You could probably buff that scratch out and you're good.
It just needs a little tuning.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a little low on oil, though.
You never need a wiring harness.
Mm-hmm. So what year is that, Chad?
It's an 03. Beaver tail?
Same as mine.
But you don't have a beaver tail, Mark.
Yours is an 03 and a half.
Yeah.
This is technically a 4.
So there's a couple jet skis.
See that jet ski? There's a couple carcasses out there.
That's another part out of mine.
Is that Hunter's boat?
Yeah.
He'd never put it back in the water?
Dude, that thing's probably shot.
I try to get rid of stuff, and then he just keeps bringing stuff.
Nice. Uh-oh. Got anyone the backlight.
Does anyone want to adopt him?
When your step shag. Hunter. Your step shag.
Oh, no, I don't mind that. That's only one. Parker. Yeah, Dad, I bought this jet ski for $150.
Dude, I couldn't pass it up.
There.
A running jet ski for $125 with a registration.
Right.
But the problem is he takes the motor, and then the rest of it sits around.
Oh, is that the motor you use for yours?
The motor, the cases are the same as my freestyle jet ski, so.
It's like a super jet motor. Yeah. Nice. Yeah, it's a 701, which is a common.
All right. My arms aren't long enough
to do. Let's kick it.
Selfies.
Ooh. What are we kicking?
We're going to grab that stator. Yeah, look at that. Full metal roof. Shag did it all himself. With just a little bit of help, right? Who helped you a little bit?
My dad did a little. Yeah,
you got some LED lighting up here, huh?
Yeah.
Nice.
Courtesy of French.
You're Shag's dad or Parker's grandfather. There, he's got everything. Whether he needs it or not, he's got one.
See, this is my workbench.
Yes.
My son seems to think it's his workbench.
It's a catch-all. Just Parker? Throw everything on it.
What? We don't want to know what that is.
No, that was in the back of the truck. That's yours, buddy.
This is mine? This one, am I your buddy?
What the hell is this?
It's like some. It's got a handle on it. Is that a handle at this end?
Hi, guys.
Hey, how are you?
Good, how are you?
It's a Mrs. Shag.
You're on camera. Smile. You're on camera.
Nice to see you. Bye.
Cameo appearance.
All right, so let's get that stator, and then... we can go. Did you figure out what that thing is?
I have no idea what it is.
Yeah, bipolar?
Yeah.
It might say on there.
I think it's...
It says right there, stainless steel rod.
It's a gun rod.
To clean a gun. I didn't even know you had any guns.
There's two people that bring stuff here. My dad and Parker.
Right.
And they both bring stuff and leave it here.
Right.
Yeah, but then you go to his house and steal things and then bring them here.
Only things I need.
I gotta buy oil.
But at least that stuff is wanted here. All right. Look at that, a man cave.
I got it like 2 hours ago.
I know. I forgot. I got home. I said I'm gonna get it when I get home. I forgot all about it.
It's a glove snowblower.
So here's Parker and his little.
Gets his driveway plowed.
Look at real little there.
Goes to Florida for the winter. Right.
Here's
it's still by a snowball.
That's a good shot. Okay. That's when I first started snowmobiling right there.
Yeah, 10 years old. Yeah. What do you got? Crutches here.
Yeah, I had a
meniscus.
ACL, MCL, meniscus.
Oh my god. Of course.
It keeps up.
Graduate.
Dirt bike accident.
Yeah. So there's the collage.
There's the famous backflip jet ski.
Oh yeah, the backflip jet ski. And then he's a hockey player too.
The hydrostatic's kind of cool. It's just quick change, so, you know.
There you go.
Yeah.
But who's this guy?
You know how like usually you roll it back. Right. Like,
who's that guy?
Just to be quick, you don't. This you guy. Have to like drive.
Oh, oh, that's Tapo Numina. He's a famous hockey player.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, we met him.
Cool. Well, you were quite young there.
Tapo Numina.
All right, come on, let's get out of here.
All right.
Here's a good Parker picture.
Right there. Yes.
How about this one?
Nice.
Mark the little turd. I would like that one.
See, what you don't know is Parker has a few other siblings, but they don't ride snowmobiles, so they don't get to be in the videos.
Ryan did for
and he's the youngest.
Hey, Vanilla Ice.
Yes. That's right.
Ryan did for a bit, and then
pretty good one.
I crashed twice riding with him, so my dad cut that
remember,
off.
Remember? Or you
is your stick bent?
Yeah.
Holy crap.
All right, we're back. We're back.
Never thought you'd let it.
That's right. Hey, careful with the lyrics. You might get a flag.
Oh, you got the cord. Right. I have one. But I gotta see what the hell this is like.
What's that, a hockey guard?
Those are motocross boots.
Oh, motocross boots. Nice. All right, we're back for blood.
Hey, you wanna see where I tore up the grass with my plow?
Your plow, you don't even have a plow.
I'm running a freaking, I got a big diesel now.
Oh, I forgot.
Shop
about
truck.
That.
I take it when I want.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh, darn.
It's got a 7.4, I think it's a 7.4 diesel in the Ford F-250.
Nice.
I never plowed with a diesel, usually with regular gas. You just gas on.
Parker's just holding that.
With a diesel, you just give it a little gas.
There you go.
Oh, Parker, you okay?
You got that, right? So, Mark is the manager of a auto shop. So he gets some perks. All right, we are back.
I'm bearing gifts. That motor is for you, baby.
Here's Mark's pit. It's dark.
Hi, Chris, say hi. Say hi. 100%
muscle.
Say hi to the TV world.
This 85 tail.
5 pounds of psycho.
Yeah, that tail is like a whip.
Yeah.
All right. So let's see. What are we gonna do to that? We gotta take the stator off of that motor. All right, so there's 3 bolts here. We're going to get them off, and then...
The big bolt, and then you need a puller.
Yeah, and then we've got to pull it. So, get back to you in a second. Okay, so Parker removed the part that the recoil grabs there. That's fully removed. Now we got to grab an impact and a big... And the house is about to explode. And remove that nut.
Right off.
Butter.
Like a glove.
So, did you ever figure out what size that socket is?
I can't read it. It's,
He doesn't know how to read.
I don't know how to read. I'm not good at reading.
Yeah. It's a little...
30.
30 millimeter.
Yep.
All right. 30 mil.
Or is that a 3? 33? 30. I think it's a 30.
Yeah. It's big.
Yeah. 31, maybe?
Jeez. Let me see.
Right there. It's a 30, I think.
Okay, so this is like some type of spacer that goes in there that you got to remove before you can remove
it. Watch out, I'm blowing stuff.
I'm sure we'll get some grief for blowing it out, and you're probably not supposed to blow it out, right? Somebody will say something. We got her. There's quite a bit of debris in there. It's all
just tore
plastic.
Up stuff, yeah. So it's nothing that I don't think would have done any real damage.
Right, but I think we're still going to change out the stator. At least, can you pull the stator out and we'll examine it?
Ow.
Before we even pull this, let's look at the other one.
So this is the stator on the donor engine. So we gotta pull that one out. We'll see which one's better.
We might use this rod off of this engine too, because it's in perfectly straight. There's no problem with that one there. Because it got hydro-locked. Not from us, though. Where'd you get this motor?
That donor ski that you were showing, or that donor.
Oh, that carcass?
Yeah, this came out of there.
Okay. It's got a carcass in the back. Not sure if that's going to make it in the video. I might throw a quick shot of it in here just to see what I'm talking about. But, yeah, you can get a lot of parts. Okay, so basically, based on Mark's visual inspection, we are not going to replace the stator. We're going to stick with the stator that's on here. There was no, metal shrapnel, nothing in there. And it wasn't running funny, so we're confident that there's nothing wrong with this stator. So we are not going to replace the stator at this point. Okay. All right, so we've got this fully reassembled. Since we are not changing the stator, we're going to now put the new recoil on it, and then we will decide whether to put the starter on before we put the motor back in.
Check that magnet tray.
Alrighty then, recoil fully installed. Now we're going to put the starter motor on, and then the last step will be to slap the motor back in.
We bought new bolts too.
Yes.
Back set bolts.
Yep. Cap bolts. So, yeah. Here we go. Alright, so we've got the starter here. We're going to put some Loctite on these chip bolts.
You really only need a tiny bit, but this thing has had lots of issues, so we're going to Loctite that bad.
Yeah, we were contemplating using red Loctite, but we didn't want to push it.
Yeah.
So blue Loctite and lock washers should do the trick.
So
that's just the first one there, and then we'll go from there. One at a time. There's three bolts, one here, one down here, and one over there that Parker's... We dry fitted them just to make sure that we had all the right length bolts and things. But now we're Loctiting. And Parker's Loctiting his fingers.
Gashed open finger.
Yes, he's got a bashed, gashed, slashed and gashed finger. He's just removing that one because we got to put the Loctite on it. And then we'll snug them up with a socket and ratchet here. Don't want to over-tighten them. So we're taking it easy here. You could easily strip aluminum threads with a steel bolt.
Parker's weak.
Yeah.
We should be using a torque wrench.
Yeah, we don't know the torque specs anyway, so... Just don't over-tighten it. You just get it nice and snug. The lock washer should do the job here, along with the Loctite.
Okay, we're good.
We're good. Starter mounted.
All right, start it up.
It's ready to go back in, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
All right. All right, so that's going to be it for now, guys. We have the motor all set and ready to go in, so let's thank Mark and Parker here. And probably upload this and then... go on to the final part where we're stabbing the motor back into the chassis there. So I want to thank you for watching. Check the links in the description. Go to...
buy some hats.
Yeah, buy some Paisteboy hats.
Buy
and
everything.
Buy it all. Check the links in the description there. I do have an Amazon affiliate page, and you could go like or follow me on Facebook. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching, guys. All right.